You want to improve shift feel and transmission durability? Raising line pressure with the Sonnax booster kit is a well-established and preferred technique, especially for a heavy-duty vehicle. The Chrysler RFE units are real oddballs, though. Unlike every other trainee out there, and I mean everyone, pressure is under the complete control of a computer system that will immediately detect and correct any deviations from the norm. This means there's only two ways to raise pressure in an RFE. Number one is install a part that works with the computer system rather than against it, or two would be to modify the transmission tune or software. Number one is where the patented Sonnax line pressure booster comes in, an easy, effective upgrade that improves holding power and torque capacity without low-speed harshness. The kit creates what's called a progressive pressure boost. It raises pressure a little, about 10 psi for engagements and low-speed shifts, then raises it more as driving conditions become increasingly demanding, up to about 25 psi total. It's really the best of both worlds. The kit won't cause excessive high line pressure like you risk with valve body mods and tuning, and especially with the RFE, subtle changes are best. They deliver better durability and are more reliable. Installing the electronic booster is really easy. No transmission or pan removal is required. It simply plugs between the vehicle harness and the transmission pressure sensor, which is found on the outside of the tranny case. The sensor is always on the passenger side, though sometimes it is hidden behind a heat shield. Some of the differences in shift feel, basically meaning shorter shifts, may adapt out over time, but the improved higher line pressure is always going to be there to keep the clutches applied. The kit also includes a stronger PR spring, which you don't have to install in the pump, but should be used if you've already pulled the transmission. The spring alone won't affect line pressure. It's only there to support the booster, and we'll explain more about that in a bit. After the booster is installed, the vehicle needs to learn how to run with higher line pressure. You can use a scan tool to do a CVI reset, or if you don't have a scan tool, do a test drive through several shift cycles at light to medium throttle. Once adapted, you'll get crisp, clean shifts, especially noticeable when the vehicle's under load, when you might otherwise expect things to get a little sloppy. Now, all that seems simple, right? It is, and yet there's a lot of confusion and misconceptions about the RFE transmission, about how this booster kit works, and even how you're supposed to tell that it is working. So let's break it down. The RFE uses a computerized closed-loop system to monitor and adjust pressure in real time. The system physically measures pressure inside the transmission and then feeds this information to the transmission computer. If line pressure is reported low, the computer causes the pressure control solenoid, also called a PCS, to raise pressure. If pressure is reported high, then the computer has the PCS lower it. This process happens instantaneously and continuously, so line pressure always meets the pre-programmed desired levels. No other automatic transmission works like this. It's very similar to how engine systems with oxygen sensors adjust and maintain air-fuel ratio on the fly. The only way around this is to physically raise pressure within the transmission while letting the computer think that it's still maintaining a different desired pressure. And that's what the electronic booster does. Once it's plugged in, it modifies the signal between the pressure sensor and the computer, so pressure is reported as slightly low, and then the computer raises line pressure in direct proportion to the modified signal. And shazam, higher line pressure. If you were to check the pressure with a scan tool, both the desired and actual pressures will appear normal. Throw an adapter tool and pressure gauge on, though, and you'll see that the physical pressure inside the transmission is actually higher. That's the booster at work, keeping the computer happy while the transmission benefits from improved shift action and clutch durability. And that's why we're all here, right? So what about the pressure regulator spring in the kit? Why do we recommend but not require it be installed? Well, the short answer is that using the spring and booster together helps optimize performance. And who doesn't want that? The long answer goes back to the pressure control solenoid. The pressure control solenoid has an operational range of about 5% to 62%. And when the electronic booster is installed without the spring, as the pressure increases, the duty cycle moves downward. And this is significant because if the duty cycle hits its lower limit of 5%, it could throw a code. It's not a common problem when the booster is used by itself, but it could occur, especially in vehicles with programmers or high system voltage. And this is where the stronger PR spring helps. It adjusts the calibration of the pressure regulator valve in the pump, allowing for higher pressure to be created at the original duty cycle instead of a lower duty cycle. And that's all it does. The electronic booster improves line pressure, and the spring is there just to support it by keeping the duty cycle close to the original operation. The booster is commonly installed without the spring, so I don't want anyone thinking they have to pull the tranny to get the benefits of this kit. But if you have the opportunity to put the spring in there to overhaul, do it. But even without it, the booster kit will work just fine. A few more things about this kit, since we often get these questions. Older versions had a simple resistor and didn't come with a spring. This newer kit, known as the RFE-LB1, is a more sophisticated design with an internal integrated chip, and it comes with a spring and works in both gas and diesel applications. So if you're looking for even more holding power, the Sonnax Booster Kit pairs great with the Sonnax Smart Tech Overdrive Clutch Housing Kit. You'll get about 25% more total torque capacity by combining the two. What you don't want to do is use the booster kit in a tranny that's already tuned for higher line pressure or in a unit that has the old school resistor mods in the circuit. So if you have any questions about anything we've covered in this video, feel free to call or email Sonnax Tech Support. We're always happy to help. Or you can find more info on all our transmission upgrades, plus lots more tech resources to help your rebuilds at sonnax.com.